All right, welcome back. You know, hopefully you're watching on Biz TV because we want the network to know that people are watching. But we also have a really fervent social media audience who tunes in. And one of our, you know, loyal viewers, Pete Malvasio, just called me and said, you look like an animal wolfing down a pizza. And on the commercials, we're on Facebook Live, so you get a little more unplugged version of what's happening. But Frank ordered pizza for the staff, so... I just want to recap by saying I'm sorry I was late today.
Sorry.
I am trying to polish up my game, and then, you know, some of my childhood friends.
Your golf game.
My golf
game.
Not
your TV game.
Not my TV game, no. Bobby Comp, Wall Street Veteran, Jimmy Munson, Greg Manos. We had a great day, and I'm not really good at doing this, but I lost.
Oh.
I don't like admitting I lose at things.
Munson
but,
won? I didn't even.
No,
I
me,
even
and Munson,
see Munson.
Me and Munson were partners. We lost to Greg Manos and Bob Compitello. Right. So it happens.
It was an
amazing day, and that's what caught
it's
me here.
It's important to be
late.
A gracious loser as well as a gracious winner.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, the only errors that I caught from you today, John, are one, you arrived here about 15 or 20 minutes late. Second, you referred to Dr. Samuel Mitchum as Dr. Samuel Witchum repeatedly.
I have the reverse of dyslexia. You see words backwards.
I wonder what that's called, seeing them upside down.
I see them upside down, so I saw the M as a W. Instead of Mitchum, I said Witchum.
Your other issue, John, is the Maker's Mark bottle is closer to you,
oh,
and I've got an empty
well,
glass.
Well, that's not an issue. And... you know, I also, it may have been like a Freudian slip,
mm-hmm.
because it was almost like, you know, witchcraft, what this guy was talking about. He was trying to, you know, make like it was okay to have Confederate statues and the Civil War about slaves. And, you know, we try to give everybody a point of view, but I didn't agree with a lot of what
he was
saying.
Well, you can disagree, but you don't have to, you know, butcher the guy's name.
Well, I can because it's, you know, mostly my show.
You have a guy, right, so one of the statues that's repeatedly being tried to be taken down is Robert E. Lee. Now, Robert E. Lee was against slavery. I don't believe he held slaves. He was discouraging... from Virginia leaving the Union. President Lincoln actually asked him to lead the Union Army. And then after the Civil War, he was one of the most prominent voices urging Southerners to accept reconciliation and accept life under the Union. And then I believe, I stand to be corrected, but I believe he donated a big portion of his estate to becoming what's now Arlington National Cemetery.
Wow.
So, you know, you could see why a lot of people take issue with, and as Dr. Mitchum pointed out, a lot of these people that were fighting for the Confederacy, they did so because their country was invaded. You know, I mean, their state, their locality, their community was invaded. I mean, President Lincoln, as much as he's lionized now, he butchered through his orders hundreds of thousands of Americans, you know, including burning farms to the ground and doing a lot of other things. I think there's a strong case to be made for why Robert E. Lee, those statues and monuments should continue to stand.
Where did we get this pizza from?
That's from Sal and Lloyd's.
Sal and Lloyd's in Eltingville.
Yeah.
It's not a bad pie.
So,
mistake in this
again,
pie.
I shouldn't be eating pizza because I see the way that I look on these monitors, and pizza is the last thing that I need, but... Sal and Lloyd's, and first of all, Nico, I would encourage you, I appreciate the fact that you gave me a slice, but I would encourage you in the future that when you take a slice of pizza,
Put the lid back on, keep it hot.
So that it doesn't immediately become cold.
Nico.
And this is a good pro tip for those of you at home, ordering pizza and serving it to guests. If you serve someone a slice and there's a remainder, which we hope there will be, close the lid. This way it doesn't get cold instantly. But I'll just say this about Sal and Lloyd's, and I don't know Sal nor Lloyd, if that's their real name.
Is this Lloyd from Dumb and Dumber? That Lloyd? Or?
No.
But yeah, so Lloyd, I don't know Christmas. I don't know Sal nor Lloyd, but and they didn't give us any kind of deal here, but their cheese, their regular cheese pie, is so cheesy that it's basically...
How cheesy is it?
Oh, it's so cheesy that they'd laugh at this joke. But a bump bump. But no, their regular cheese slice is so cheesy that it's basically the equivalent of a regular pizzeria's extra cheese. So what I did, I said, let me go crazy. let me go crazy because Meredith's not here and she was not going to raise a fuss about us eating dairy.
Oh my God.
Let me order the extra cheese. So I'm actually eating right now for a price of an additional $3.50, the extra cheese slice from Sal & Lloyd's, which is pretty interesting.
And by the way, speaking of Meredith, she passed by the other night and I prepared a wonderful home-cooked meal. And I make, if there's one thing I make good, it's probably the best garlic bread you've ever tasted. Homemade garlic bread. That's like the one thing I can do good. It's pretty easy.
You can
do a special recipe. I do well. And she actually wanted me to show her the ingredients on the bag that the Italian bread came in because she doesn't eat eggs or dairy.
Oh, she doesn't eat eggs either.
Well, you know, then I got into that debate with her after I proved that there was no eggs in the bread. Mm-hmm. It was made with, you know, other ingredients. But then I questioned her on that, and she said that, you know, certain eggs that aren't, that are like free-range chickens who aren't caged, and, you know, she can go down there and pet them, I guess, and she knows that they're not being harmed. She'll eat eggs, but she doesn't want commercial eggs in the bread.
Well, I will tell you this. So, you know, we generally buy free-range eggs in the Morano household, but recently someone gave us some eggs that were not free-range. And my wife, she cracked open a free-range egg versus a non-free-range egg. The difference in the color, texture, and thickness of this egg, once it was opened, was very noticeable. So
okay.
I do think there's something to be said for eating eggs from chickens that are healthier raised.
There's also some stuff on the internet you might want to look at that every so often, a free-range egg, you get a little baby chick in the egg.
Is that true?
You know, like a formed embryo sometimes happens in them, which is probably, that's a little traumatic for me. And I mean, you know, I'm not judging anyone, but, you know, try the garlic bread. I'll be here all weekend. You know what I'm saying? Don't look into the ingredients, but lots of ground covered today.